Hi everybody, it's me, it's Dr. Kestler from Lorain County Community College with another COVIDio. Today is the 21st. My temperature today is 21. My temperature today is 97.2 degrees Fahrenheit or 36.2 degrees centigrade. And I'm checking it every day and I'm still staying inside anyways. Yesterday got me kind of homesick for one of my former hometowns, Boston. So eventually there will be a marathon, my fellow Bostonians. And there's a little message here about social distancing there. Okay, I'm gonna start talking about back to the prison in Ohio. I wanna go back to the prison. I brought it up yesterday. Yesterday, of course, had a dramatic change in numbers in Ohio. And this is, there is a whole bunch of people who are infected with COVID-19 in the prison. 18, I believe it is 1,800 people are infected with COVID-19. And that's out of a population of about 2,500 individuals. So it's a good significant fraction of the population. There are at Marion Correctional Institute, there is a number of people who are have zero symptoms. And I just want to quickly put a preface on this. There's 0% symptoms now at this time. That does not mean that they're not going to develop them in a week or so. We will see. They were all screened yesterday or over the weekend. There was a massive screening and testing, and it is going to be worth noting what happens to this population. I think this is going to be very, very interesting and will have information for all of us going forward. So we're going to track that as time goes on. You'll notice that if you look at the data, this is from today's data. This looks a lot like yesterday's, but there are 2,100 cases in all of Marion County. There are 25 hospitalizations, which is, if you look down to Cuyahoga County, which is where I live, you'll see there's 400 hospitalizations at this point. So the question is why aren't there? It may have something to do with the population. It's a unique population. It may have something to do with the large number of people who are asymptomatic right now. Maybe this virus is just starting in that population. At any rate, we will see where this goes. I have already alerted my students about this, and I've already alerted my students who are working on COVID units, and those of you who I didn't get to, here I am telling you right now, there is a potential for an increase in the number of people needing health care in Marion, and they're going to be probably distributed between the Columbus and Cleveland. So be prepared to increase your census in the hospital with a rather unique population of individuals. So far, there's only one death in Marion County. In Lorain County, we see those of you who want to look down at the Lorain County, because that's where I work, and most of my folks are from Lorain County that are listening here. We have a fewer number of cases, but an awful lot of deaths. That's probably because of a couple of nursing home cases, and nursing homes are places where there is a huge, huge problem. Speaking of the older populations, I just want to take a second here and talk about today was Holocaust Memorial Day, and it's worthwhile thinking about that population, because this is the older population are the people who experienced World War II and all of the trappings of it, and it's very important that we honor them and remember them and protect them, be the helper for them. They're looking for helpers right now, and I think it's our job to do the best we can. All right, let me move on. I want to talk about some, I think, good news, and temper it with some advice news. I might get a little preachy here, I guess, but it is informed advice. First of all, If you look at the daily deaths in the United States, if you look at the daily cases, new cases, things are looking better. The deaths kind of hard to say whether that's going in the right direction. It looks like it is going in the right direction. It's a little choppy right now. So time will tell if that flattens out like it did in Italy and France. We saw these numbers come down and down, lower and lower. And so that is really good kind of news. And the other thing that I think gives us some hope as well is that if we look at this next slide where I'm showing all of the cases of COVID in every single country that you can think of. I've highlighted Russia, and the reason I'm interested in what's going on in Russia is because they seem to have one of the fastest continual growth rate right now. Why that is, yen is na you. But we will be watching that. But I want to show you, you see how you can't see all the countries. That's actually the point of this slide. The reason I'm showing you this slide is because you see that there is everybody on here all at once. And I have to tell you, that's kind of a good thing. That is a good thing because the entire world is experiencing COVID-19 simultaneously. And if that is the case, that means the disease will mature or fade out or whatever at the same time. So if we all get on the same page and we all do the right things and we all, you'll notice how many countries are starting to flatten out. Even the United States is starting to flatten out at the top. Italy is flattening out. South Korea has been flat for quite a while. All of these countries have that nice straight line there. That means there's on this logarithmic curve, there's no more new cases. The new cases these are cumulative cases, and they're starting to flatten out there, which is a good thing. That's a good thing that we want to do. So we may all get through it. There will be no reservoirs of this. There will be no continuing drip, drip, drip. So we can maybe get through this all. But I do want to remind you, this slide here, I can't get this slide out of my head. This is from 1918. I think we do very well at looking at our past. One of the good things about looking at 1918 is that this is 2020. And the fact that I can talk about 1918 in 2020 means that we all made it. We made it through 1918, which was clearly, I'll tell you, it is going to go down as worse than this. We are going to go through this better than that. And we're going to go through it. That's the big message there. We're all going to get through this. And that is good news. But look at Denver. This is the Denver data. And at November 11th, they put in interventions. I'm going to just repeat what I said yesterday because I really want to drive this home. They had interventions introduced in October. They took them away. They saw some decline. They took them away. And then they saw a second surge. What we have to do on this particular curve right now is take it all the way down. Take it down to zero, and then we can lift up. And then we'll be in a much, much better place. I spent the afternoon listening to the governor and talking about, and Dr. Acton, governor of Ohio, I mean, Mike DeWine and Dr. Acton, talking about what it's going to look like in the beginning of May. It is not going to be everybody go back to the same all at once. No, it's going to be a controlled open. And will there be flare-ups? Oh, hell yeah, there will be flare-ups, and we have to respond to them. I am going to leave you with a picture here of, before we go to our final slide, the find the helper slide. I just want to show you where the helper is in this picture here. And that is the guy who is helping people in the hospital and helping people outside of the hospital. And that's who the helper is. And so I just want to make sure you all keep up the good work. Keep up being the helpers. And I'm going to stop right there and thank you all for tuning in. I will say that I hope you are good to each other. Make sure you're good to each other. And the best way you can be good to each other is by staying home. And may you persist like a lentivirus.